economic impact has been huge. We see it's had an effect on our trade deficit, our mm-hmm. public finances, mm-hmm. our infrastructure, resources. We've seen that rents have gone up because so many Syrians are looking for places to live. Commodity prices have gone up. But at the same time, wages have gone down because Syrians and Jordanians are competing for jobs. We are having to take in so many huge numbers in our hospitals, in our schools. We have 120,000 Syrian students that were unaccounted for that now are attending our schools. So more than half our schools are now doing double shifts. They're overcrowded. The teachers are really struggling to cope. And a lot of the children that are coming in have psychological needs and social needs that need to be addressed. So both the Syrian and the Jordanian children are suffering as a result of this. And that's a real shame, because I believe that education is the first line of defense, not just against poverty and unemployment, but against extremism and instability.
You've talked about justice, equality, our young people need hope. Mm-hmm. For young Jordanians and young Syrian refugees who don't have any hope at the moment, how concerned are you about the fermenting of extremist violence?
I think we all have to be concerned about extremist violence. I think this is something that touches everybody in the world. No one can actually think that this is not their problem, because it is. And when I say this is a fight between extremism and moderation, I mean it's extremists on all sides and all religions, and moderates on all sides and all religions. So I think this is something we all have to think about. We have to see that it is our battle. Extremists historically always rely on the complacency of moderates. They think that we're not going to do anything. And they mobilize and we don't. They form networks and we don't. We have to be out there. We have to be active. You know, each one of us has a role to play in really fighting for it, because this is our life that we're fighting for, and the life of our children.